Next is a class from the Srimad Bhagavatam, 2nd Canto, 3rd Chapter, text number 4, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on May 24, 1972, in Los Angeles.
One who desires to be absorbed in the impersonal Brahma-jyoti effulgence should worship the master of the Vedas, Lord Brahma, or Brihaspati, the learned priest. One who desires powerful sex should worship the heavenly king, Indra. And one who desires good progeny should worship the great progenitors called the Prajapatis. One who desires good fortune should worship Durga Devi, or the superintendent of the material world. One desiring to be very powerful should worship fire. And one who aspires after money only should worship the Vasus. One should worship the root reincarnation of Lord Shiva if he wants to be a great hero. One who wants a large stock of grain should worship Aditi. One who desires a worldly kingdom should worship Vishwadev. And one who wants to be popular with the general mass of population should worship the Satya demigod.
So, these are the problems. We have to seek exactly like that. It's like government departments. If you want to have this, you have to go to a particular department. Building department, water department, so many, electric department. Many departments, tax department, income tax department, support tax department, vyavasadika buddhi ekiha kurunandana bahusaka janantascha buddhi abhyavasayina. So there are many statements in the Bhagavad Gita that in Indian villages still, there are different wells. One well is meant for washing dishes. Another well is meant for taking bath. Another well is meant for washing cloth. Another well is meant for drinking water. So Krishna says, there are different wells for different purposes. But when you go to the river, all the purposes will be served. You can wash your dishes, you can wash your cloth, you can take bath, and then you take drinking water. Similarly, all these desires, of course a devotee has no material desire. Unless one is free from all these material desires. These are all material desires. Somebody wants to be powerful, somebody wants to possess wealth, somebody wants to have beautiful wife, somebody wants to possess grains and worldly kingdom. There is no limit of our desires. And there are department also. You can fulfill your desires. Janti deva brata devan, pitri janti pitri brata. So this is kindness, mercy of Krishna, that He has given you facility if you want to fulfill your desire. But all of them are kama. In each, every line, the word is used, kama. You have marked it. Just like annadhyā kāmastu aditi. Annadhyā, anna means grains. There are different kinds of grains. That is also wanted. Annadhyā kāmastu. kama. But you won't find here a meat eater. No. That is not at all. That is aboriginal. That is not for human being. Anya, you can desire anna, grains. You can desire to become king. You can desire to have nice wife. These are natural. But there is not a single sentence here you'll find that desiring to eat meat, egg, flesh, no. That is beyond human jurisdiction. They are not meant for human being. So, these are the different departments. If you want to take facility of quickly getting some benefit, jajanti iha devata, kankhantam karmanang siddhi, karmanang siddhi, jajanti iha devata. For particular type of fulfillment of your desire, you can worship the particular type of demigod. This is recommended in the Shastra for the less intelligent class of men. Still, it may be questioned that why Vedas have, if the ultimate goal is to reach the Supreme Personality of Godhead, why the Vedas have prescribed a different demigod worship? Yes. That is replied in the Bhagavad Gita. Tad bhavati alpa medhasam. Those who are less intelligent, for them, not for the first class intelligent. Those who are Krishna conscious, they are first class intelligent. They don't want anything beyond Krishna, that's all. They don't want to know anything except Krishna. The advantage is, if you can know Krishna, then you know everything. And if you get Krishna, you get everything. Therefore, this conclusion cannot be perceived by less intelligent class. Exactly like that.